Hey guys, James Wedmore here. And today, we're doing a video makeover. We're doing something pretty exciting, pretty cool, and pretty simple. We're sitting here right now over on the download page for one of my special offers called the YouTube Traffic Report. Side note, if you haven't downloaded this and read it already, you need to do it now. The link is in the description. This is the download slash thank you page for where you can access the report. And as you can see right here, there is a video that I have here. I try to use video as much as possible, as should you. What we're gonna do today, which will take only a few minutes, is actually give this existing video a complete makeover. And you're gonna see exactly what I mean by that in a second. We are going to use a fancy, sexy new software called Easy Video Suite that I'm absolutely in love with. So let's go ahead and get started now. Okay, as you can see right here on my download page, I'm just using a YouTube video. Okay, this is actually an unlisted YouTube video, and it auto plays when people come to this page. And real simple, real basic, right? And that's a perfectly fine, normal or average way to do things. But you're not normal and average, are you? You're taking things to the next level. So let me show you in the next few minutes how we can take this video already on YouTube without doing any crazy work to it and make it just like 10 times cooler. So let's head on over to Easy Video Suite. Here I am in the dashboard area, and let's see what we can do. The first thing I want to do is click the upload button here. Now, because this video is already on the web, I would click the upload from the web button. However, if it wasn't already on YouTube or it was a brand spanking new video, I can upload it from my computer as well. I have other videos talking about the difference between this, but because it's already on YouTube and I want to do this as quickly as possible, let's click this button. Okay, the next thing it wants us to do is simply enter the URL of the YouTube video. That's really simple. I have that already. I'm just going to paste it in there and click import. As soon as you press that button, you're going to be taken to a page that's going to show a preview of your video, and then you just simply click yes to import the video. Okay, all we have to do is find that exact video. Here it is right here up at the top, and we're going to click settings. In this tutorial, we're not going to talk about profiles in Easy Video Suite. This is a very cool way to save some time and do some universal settings for our feature for our videos. So if you're doing a ton of videos, you want the same features, you can create a specific profile. I'm going to just select default profile, click that button, and move on to the next step. This is where it gets really fun and really exciting. What we're going to do is just get creative and start doing a few other cool things to our video. The first one being the dimensions. Now, whenever you're doing the dimensions on a video, you usually need to focus on the width because every video is gonna be in a 16:9 format, or at least it should be. And I'm just gonna type in 500 for my width, and that'll readjust the height automatically. Now, there's a few other simple settings on here like auto buffer. I'm gonna go ahead and click yes on that, as well as auto play. I'm not gonna spend too much more time on any of the other settings for this first part here. We're gonna go ahead and click next. Now, on this second option of settings, we get to customize our player. Now, as you can see here, there are a ton of different players that we can use. I'm gonna go ahead and stay with this one with the checkbox. I'm not really gonna go too much into that. Now, we have some other cool stuff, like on mouse over, we can display some social sharing functions. I'm not gonna do that on this video because it's not really my intention to share this page. This is just a download page that I make putting this video on so people will download my report. But here is something that is really cool, and this is one of my favorite functions, and this is called player entrance. When the page loads, you can have the actual player, the video itself, do something really cool, an action, an animation. Let me show you an example. We have all these from roll in to fade in to pulse to flip in horizontally or even light speed. Let's see bounce in from the left. And if you look up here at the top of your screen, I will do it again. And the player actually bounces in from the left. I love that. I'm gonna keep that one just like that. Now, as you can see, there's also plenty of other options on this page, like adding a watermark or a logo to the corner of your video, having different options for how your controls display on the page, the player displays, and even things like this, which I get really excited about, password protecting your videos. If you wanna make private members only videos, you can do that very quickly, very easily. So that's all I'm gonna do for this one, and I'm gonna click next. Now, on this settings page, one of the most exciting things, one of my favorite things, is we can further customize the frame in which the video player is encompassed by. So we have all these different cool designs. I'm sure they'll even upload more in the future, but I like this one right here. It looks like I'm playing it inside an iMac. I could also do an iPad or an iPhone setting. Let's go ahead and click this one and click next. Now on the next page of settings is something that's even more cool. This is the option to turn on social viral sharing functionability for your videos. Now, I'm personally not gonna do it in this video just because I'm using this cool kind of frame. If I click yes, it adds a bar below it and I didn't really like that. Plus I've already got something on my download page where people can do it, but check out what you can do. If you click yes, you can drag things like Facebook, you can then you can choose the title, the URL, etc. that you want to use. You can throw in a Google Plus. Actually, we just need to do this on one line. A tweet button. And let's see, it'll tell you what you want the default tweet to be. All that cool stuff. So you can have all these social sharing functions on here, which I just love. This is something that you definitely want to take advantage of, and I'll do some more training on this in the future, but let's continue. Now I went to the final page of the setting in order to finalize my video, and it's asked me a question: do you want to add interactive events onto the timeline of your video? What does that mean? Well, we're about to find out, so I'm gonna go ahead and click yes. Okay, now I have two types of events or actions that I can put into my video. The one on the left is events, which means a certain time in the video I can have something triggered, which will cause something like an opt-in box, a button, a call to action button, etc. to display. The one on the right is chapters. Now, I'm very excited to be using this because for my training videos and my membership programs, I can organize my videos much easier when I have links to chapters so people can skip ahead and repeat with just a simple click of a button. For this and all intents and purposes of the case study I'm showing you today, we are going to click on the events one. Okay, this is where it gets really cool. We're going to identify what the event is that we want to happen, when it's going to happen, and all that good stuff, okay? So the first thing I want to do, if we go back to my video here, is my number one goal is to get people to make sure to download the free report that I have created for them. So I'm actually going to have a button appear inside the video as soon as I mention it so people can actually click in the video in order to do that. So let's do it now. Okay, I went ahead and added a second event, another thing that'll pop up. This is really cool, and I can select these. You can see them up here. This is my entire video timeline. I see the first one up here. I can edit it at any time, and I can go to here and edit this one at any time. Pretty cool. I can do this a lot more. I can add a lot of other cool stuff like an intro and an outro. Okay, you can have it redirect when the video is done. It goes to another web page. This is also really cool. I'm not gonna do it for this video, and you can kind of see why because of the type of video I'm doing. This is all I need. I am done, guys. All I gotta do is get my embed code, and the only way I need to do that is click this button right here. Hey, here we are with the finished product. This is the page where you get your embed code and save this onto your site. Really self-explanatory, you just want to copy this. What I want to do first is make sure I check this, at least for what I'm doing. I want to center my video, so I click on this, and I'm just gonna copy it. So let's go ahead and check it out over on my site. Okay, now this was the old version of the download page. You can see my YouTube video right here. I've already added the code to the back end of my WordPress blog, my content management system, so this should be all good to go. Fingers crossed, let's reload the page. And boom goes the dynamite. As you can see, the video just flips right in there like that. I can go ahead, I put a little image here that says click play to get the most out of your free report. We go ahead and play it.
Hey there, James Wedmore here, and thank you so much for subscribing and opting in. Below, as promised, is your copy of the personal report I've put together for you.
And as you can see, I've got my little action that comes in so you can download the report from inside the video. How freaking cool is that? Okay, so once again, this was a super short and simple tutorial to show you how to create an absolute makeover for your videos and get more results out of them. Now, I only scratched the surface of what is possible with Easy Video Suite. We can employ tracking. We can employ social sharing options. We can do a lot more stuff, as you saw, a lot more customization, links, and actions and organization inside the video. Things that can be triggered outside of the video, like actually on the web page. Imagine having an image, a graphic, or a link pop up at a certain time in the video on the web page, not just in the video, on the web page. You can have opt-in forms, buy forms, or buy buttons, all that type of stuff. I am freaking out about this software right now. It's called Easy Video Suite. This is hands down the best software on taking your video and video marketing to the next level. It is quickly becoming an essential staple for anyone who is using video on the internet to market their business. You need this for 2013. There is a link in the description box below this video to learn more about this tool. Watch some other of my video trainings that's coming up, my tutorials, my reviews. I love every single thing about this software. I know the owner personally, Josh Bartlett, and he's put a lot of time, effort, energy, and money into the creation of this product. So go ahead, click the link below this video to learn more about Easy Video Suite and the limitless potential of what you can do with your videos. I'm James Wedmore. Thanks so much for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video. Make sure to subscribe. Alright, click the link. I'm crappy.
Yep, it's recording. Ha ha!